Sound! Attention! November 2015, the 240th birthday of the United States Marine Corps. Sound! Adjutant's call! The colors are now on the field for rededication on this, our 240th birthday. As the name of each unit present is called, their organizational color will come to the carry and face inboard, signifying the presence of the unit called. Second Marine Expeditionary Force. Marine Regiment. Marine Raider Support Group. Marine Raider Regiment. Regiment, 2nd Marine Logistics Group. School of Infantry East. Marine Corps Engineer School. Deployment Processing Command. Naval Hospital Camp Lejeune.
Let us pray. Almighty Father, we give you thanks for the blessings of liberty and freedom. We pause to give thanks today for the honor and courage of United States Marines, both past and present. As we celebrate the 240th birthday of the Marine Corps, we remember with special gratitude those who have carried the Corps' banner throughout its noble history. Some have fallen in defense of our nation, but others have marched on, keeping alive our heritage of freedom and justice for all. Grant, Lord, to each of us the courage and strength to continue the high ideals and expectations of the Marine Corps. May we keep faith with those who have gone before us, and may we take the torch of freedom into the future of this nation and the world. In your mighty name we pray, amen.
Fire detail, color guards, at 10. Present.
Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
And stood with Andrew Jackson at New Orleans. The Marines
was a task well done. The Royal 1812 service dress uniform is worn by Private Terrell Scott from Compton, California. November 10th, 1848, Mexico City. The first troops to enter the Citadel were United States Marines. Major Twiggs, second in command to General Scott, fell at the head of his troops at Chapultepec. Captain Terrett led the 20 surviving Marines through the gates of the city. Brigadier General Henderson inspired his Marines with a spirit of courage, and a new banner was unfurled, emblazoned with the motto, "From Tripoli to the halls of Montezuma." November 10, 1861. A nation divided. Marines continued to share in the gallant deeds of the Navy. Aboard more than 100 ships, Marines manned the guns and rifles, which were largely responsible for the destruction of the Confederate fleet and the blockade of the South. At Harper's Ferry, Bull Run, Fort Fisher, Norfolk, and Pensacola, Marines continued to fight their personal battles. The Civil War fatigue dress is being worn by Private Brett Hickman from Salina, Arkansas. A new era and the Spanish-American War. Marines were serving aboard the Maine in Havana Harbor. Marines were with Commodore Dewey at Manila Bay, and Huntington's Vince Quick and Private William Anthony fought as strangers to fear. The Philippines, Puerto Rico, Guam, Hawaii, Wake were all advanced naval bases. And Marines on the threshold of a new century had their work cut out for them. The Spanish-American War Tropical Uniform is being worn by Private First Class Bobby McKenzie from Lexington, Kentucky. Smiths Grove, Kentucky. November 10, 1933, the Banana Wars. Following the First World War, peace prevailed in our Banana Wars. 1936 uniform is worn by Private Simon Lee from Bronx, New York. November 10, 1942. The world is once again at war. World War II. At the end of the war, the Corps had expanded to 6 divisions, with a comparable number of air wings, as well as numerous other support and special units. The most famous of these were the Raiders and Bella Marines. At Guadalcanal, the Marines launched the first American land offensive of the Pacific Theater. It was here that marked the first time the Japanese were stopped on land. The Japanese lost more than an hour. They lost their legend of invincibility. Throughout its history, women had not played a role as part of the Corps. The only exception to this was for a short period of time during being worn by Private Rolando Cosera from Leonardtown, Maryland. The World War II Women's Summer Service Uniform is being worn by Private First Class Susanna Elliott from Stratford, Oklahoma. Back in Korea. New names are heard now. Toko Ri, chilled weather uniform, is being worn by Private Jawan Richardson from Columbia, South Carolina. November 10, 1965, Dominican Republic by Private First Class Alec Boravica from Ortonville, Michigan. November 10, 1983, Beirut, a Corps trained for conventional contingencies and remained forward deployed with the fleet. In 1983 and 1984, the Marines again found themselves ashore in Lebanon. This time, Marines in Beirut drew fire as part of a four nation peacekeeping force. One of the rotational Marine battalions fell victim to a terrorist attack, in which a fourth of its Navy and Marine personnel were killed. Emerging undaunted from the rubble, the survivors and a relief battalion continued their present mission until withdrawn 6 months later. Almost immediately after the Beirut bombing, other Marines played a successful role in a coup de main on the Caribbean island of Grenada, ousting the Cubans and radicals in control. Marines exploited light resistance to dash across the island and relieve pressure on brought-down paratroopers and rangers in a novel 96-hour intervention. In 1990, Marines participated in Operation Just Cause in Panama to restore order and democracy to the Panamanian people. That same year, Marine forces deployed to Saudi Arabia after Iraqi forces invaded Kuwait. These forces proved their worth during Operation Desert Storm, when they sliced through Iraqi defenses and liberated Kuwait. Camp Lejeune, Camp Pendleton, Okinawa, Guantanamo Bay, the Far East, Liberia, Somalia, Haiti, Kosovo, Afghanistan, Djibouti, and Iraq. Our Marine Air Ground Logistics team has retained a few good men and women with dedication and devotion. Let us reflect on those Marines who upheld the honor of our great nation. Remember also the parents, spouses, and children of the deployed Marines who with much sacrifice and fortitude provide the necessary love and support that make up our Marine Corps family. For 240 years,
The Marines of our Corps have always been true to their faith, our nation, and our motto. Semper Fidelis, always faithful. The Beirut, Lebanon utility uniform is being worn by Private First Class Bradley Andrews from Boston, Massachusetts. The Desert Storm uniform is being worn by Private Javier Ballon from Chicago, Illinois. The Marine Aviator uniform is being worn by Private Eric Englehart from Lombard, Illinois. And the Marpat Digital Utility uniform is being worn by Private Galen Nix from Flagstaff, Arizona. For 240 years, the Marines of our Corps have remained steadfast and true to the ideals that make our nation great. From the decks of the bottomless shroud to the modern ships that support us today, Marines have proven themselves as history's finest soldiers of the sea. At this moment in time, it is fitting to pay tribute to those untold thousands of men and women who have fought, bled, and died to ensure our freedom. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we read our roll call of honor. The Revolutionary War. The Barbary War. The War of 1812. The Mexican War. The Civil War. The Spanish-American War. World War I. The Banana Wars. World War II. Korea. Dominican Republic and Vietnam. The Mayo Gres Rescue, Lebanon, Grenada, Panama, Liberia, Southwest Asia, Somalia, Haiti, Kosovo, Afghanistan, and Iraq.
Sincere thanksgiving for the bountiful evidence of your rich blessing upon our nation. As we rededicate ourselves to your trust.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, now taking their positions are Brigadier General Thomas D. Wiley, Commanding General, and Sergeant Major Paul A. Berry. Sergeant Major of Marine Corps Installations East, Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune. They are accompanied with today's oldest and youngest Marines present. On November 1st, 1921, John A. Lejeune, 13th Commandant of the Marine Corps, directed that a reminder of the honorable service of the Corps be published by every command to all Marines throughout the globe on the birthday of the Corps. Since that day, Marines have continued to distinguish themselves on many battlefields and foreign shores in war and peace. On this 240th birthday of the Corps, in compliance with the will of the 13th Commandant, Article 38, United States Marine Corps Manual, edition of 1921, is republished as follows. On November 10, 1775, a Corps of Marines was created by a resolution of the Continental Congress. Since that date, many thousand men have borne the name Marine. In memory of them, it is fitting that we who are Marines should commemorate the birthday of our Corps by calling to mind the glories of its long and illustrious history. The record of our Corps is one which will bear comparison with that of the most famous military organizations in the world's history. During 90 of the 147 years of its existence, the Marine Corps has been in action against the nation's foes. From the Battle of Trenton to the Argonne, Marines have won foremost honors in war, and in the long era of tranquility at home, generation after generation of Marines have grown gray in war in both hemispheres and in every corner of the seven seas, that our country and its citizens might enjoy peace and security. In every battle and skirmish since the birth of our Corps, Marines have acquitted themselves with the greatest distinction, winning new honors on each occasion, until the term Marine has come to signify all that is highest in military efficiency and soldierly virtue. This high name of distinction and soldierly repute, we who are Marines today have received from those who preceded us in the Corps. With it, we also receive from them the essential spirit which has animated our Corps from generation to generation and has been the distinguishing mark of the Marine in every age. So long as that spirit continues to flourish, Marines will be equal to every emergency in the future, as they have been in the past, and the men of our nation will regard us as worthy successors to the long line of illustrious men who have served as soldiers of the sea since the founding of the Corps. This inspiring message of our 13th Commandant has left its mark in the hearts and minds of all Marines. By deed and act, from Guadalcanal to Iwo Jima, from Incheon to the Korean Armistice, and interventions from Lebanon to the Dominican Republic, and from the opening battles in Vietnam to the Mayaguez rescue, Marines have continued to epitomize those qualities which are their legacy. The success which they have achieved in combat and the faith they have borne in peace will continue. The Commandant and our many friends have added their hearty praise and congratulations on this, our 240th birthday. 10 November 2015, a message from the Commandant of the Marine Corps. when the Continental Congress raised up two battalions of Marines in 1775. It launched the greatest fighting force the world has ever known. A force revered globally for its uncommon valor, unparalleled adaptability, and ferocious tenacity. Over the past 240 years, the battlefields and equipment have changed, but the spirit of the United States Marine Corps has prevailed in every clime and place. 100 years ago, Marine Corps Recruit Depot Paris Island opened its doors as the first base dedicated solely to making Marines. Since then, hundreds of thousands of men and women have been forged into elite warriors at Paris Island, Marine Corps Recruit Depot San Diego, and the basic school in Quantico. Each recruit had a different reason for stepping onto the yellow footprints, but all are unified by the intangible traits that characterize United States Marines and the remarkable legacy that has carried on across generations. Whether you served on the hallowed grounds of Belleau Wood, fought on the iconic island battlefields of World War II, navigated the harsh terrain and climate of the Chosin Reservoir or Vietnam, conducted assaults during Desert Storm, marched on Baghdad, fought in close combat in Fallujah, or conducted combat operations in Afghanistan. Everyone who wears the Eagle, Globe, and Anchor is a member of that storied legacy. As we celebrate 240th birthday of our Corps, we pay tribute to fine men and women who carry our colors into the future. And we extend heartfelt thanks to our families for their steadfast support. Our 26th Commandant, General Lewis Wilson, once said, "In the last analysis, what the Marine Corps becomes is what we make of it during our respective watches." And that watch of each Marine is not confined to the time he spends on active duty. It lasts as long as he is proud to bear the title of United States Marine. Thank you all for guarding the legacy of our Corps during your watch. Happy birthday, Marines. Semper Fidelis, Robert B. Deller, General, U.S. Marine Corps, Commandant of the Marine Corps. It is a tradition in the United States Marine Corps that the first piece of cake be presented to the oldest and youngest Marines on active duty. Brigadier General Thomas D. Wiley, Commanding General, Marine Corps Installations East, Marine Corps Base Camp Lejeune, will cut the cake. Brigadier General Wiley will present the cake to the oldest active duty Marine present, Colonel Michael L. Scalise. Colonel Scalise is from Hampton, Iowa, and is currently serving as the Assistant Chief of Staff, G4, Marine Corps Installations East. He has served 26 years, 11 months in our beloved Corps. Colonel Scalise was born on July 30, 1963. Colonel Scalise will now present a piece of cake to the youngest Marine present, Private First Class Riley T. Wilson. PFC Wilson is from Utica, Ohio, and is currently assigned to Lima Company, School of Infantry East. PFC Wilson enlisted in the Marine Corps on August 12, 2014. PFC Wilson was born on December 12, 1995. States Marine Corps, and to honor the achievements and remember the selfless service and sacrifice of all Marines.